A subscriber to the channel asked me the following question. How do we create a kiosk that displays an external page, but whose content is slightly and automatically reloaded at regular intervals to create, for example, an airport-style display board? Well, the answer is really simple. We will create an HTML page and place it inside our Raspberry, and this HTML page will contain an iframe, that is, a frame capable of displaying external pages. With a few lines of JavaScript code, we will then tell this iframe to reload its content at regular intervals. Let's go to the computer right away to see how it's done. And here's the page that needs to be created. It is a very simple HTML page with an iframe object and some JavaScript code inside. What is an iframe object? Let's go see it right away. Loading this page, you can see a sort of square inside which a page is loaded, in this case, a Wikipedia page. In fact, the iframe has an ID attribute, which is a name that identifies it within the page, and then a SRC object, which is the address, the URL, of the page that it needs to display. So here you will put the address of the page you want to use. The JavaScript code essentially indicates that every 20 milliseconds, through the setInterval function, every 20 milliseconds, or 20 seconds, you can obviously change the time. It essentially calls the refreshIframe function that will reload the content of the page. How does it do this? First and foremost, we declare a variable I referring to the DOM object of our iframe. Specifically and precisely identifying within the document page the particular element whose ID is called my iframe, and we carefully store it in the designated and specific variable I. Then subsequently, we proceed to store in the variable named SRC, a JavaScript variable, the SRC attribute of this iframe, so that we can set it aside and continuously and repeatedly instruct it to reload, and display that content. In fact, the refresh iframe function simply and clearly states that the object identified as my iframe should have its SRC attribute set equal to SRC, so we effectively and efficiently reload it. This may seem quite poor because we can visualize the entire page. So within the attribute, of the iframe tag, we set a width equal to 100%, meaning we explicitly tell it that the width should be as wide as the entire page, as wide as the entire browser window, and the same for the height, which is also 100%. Now let's reload this page and see that it is already much better, but the border and the scroll bar are still visible, so let's tell it. Set the border equal to 0, which is a crucial step in ensuring that the visual appearance of the page aligns with our expectations. At this point, it looks like a normal page, seamlessly integrated with the rest of the content. The scroll bar, which is typically a distinct element, now appears to be part of the page itself. This is because it is no longer the browser page. In the traditional sense, it has transformed into something different, no longer the frame set page we started with. This change indicates that we are on the right track. At this point, what we need to do is load this page onto our Raspberry Pi. This involves a series of steps to ensure that the page is displayed correctly and can be interacted with as intended. To display a page that makes sense, one that can actually be seen, and is being reloaded dynamically, I created a dynamic page that points to my PC. This setup makes it appear as if it were an external page, displaying a counter that updates in real time. I named this page readcounter.php, and it serves a specific purpose. So, let's reload this page and observe the changes. Let's immediately look at the code, which is designed to connect to a database. It performs a simple yet effective operation, counting the rows in a table and then outputting an H1 tag with the text counter, followed by the number of rows it found. The task will be to demonstrate this functionality by saying, OK, this is my database. It currently has 2 rows. I will insert a row now, and the rows will increase to 3. We should see that this counter goes from 2 to 3, reflecting the change. Now let's see if it works. I set it to update every 20 seconds. Okay, now it has gone to 3, so we are indeed seeing on my PC that it is working as expected. Let's insert another row, and then another row again. Now there are 5 rows. Let's see if it updates. I specifically set a time of 20 seconds for this purpose. Here it is. Counter 5. So things are working perfectly on my PC. Now let's upload this file to the Raspberry Pi. I usually use WinSCP for this task, which is a reliable tool for transferring files. We will upload it to the HomePi folder, which is the user directory we created in previous lessons. Let's upload the auto-refresh file, here it is. And this auto-refresh file will connect to this site, which for it is still an external page, in this case, my PC, but still an external page. It will open this frame and reload the content every 20 seconds, ensuring that the information displayed is always up to date. At this point, we connect with PuTTY on our Raspberry Pi, a tool that allows us to manage the device remotely. We edit the usual file, ensuring that the connection remains stable and hasn't dropped. We edit the usual file, AutoStart, and in the part we saw where we specified the address of the site to open, this time we write without quotes instead of the URL of the site. We write em, we said home.pi. This step is crucial for ensuring that the system knows exactly where to look for the necessary files and how to execute them properly. The web page located at home, pi.autorefresh.html, is designed to automatically refresh itself periodically. So, Chromium, which is a widely used open source web browser project, will open a specific file that is residing within the Raspberry Pi, a small and affordable computer that is popular for various projects. This file will then have a live frame pointing to the remote site, which is a location on the internet that we are interested in monitoring. Let's save our progress, reboot the system, and see what happens next. Okay, let's proceed to reboot the Raspberry Pi and observe that it restarts successfully. Here, the page with the frame set, which is a collection of HTML frames, has been opened. We can see that the counter, which is a numerical indicator, is currently at 5. Now let's go back to my personal computer and increase these rows in the database. Let's insert one new entry, execute the command, go back here and see if the counter updates as expected. Okay, the counter is now at 6, and it hasn't touched anything manually. It auto-updated automatically. Let's go back, insert another entry again, come back here, and observe the counter, which is still at 6, but it should go to 7 after the update. Here it is. So this is a very simple page that demonstrates the refresh functionality, if we want to call it that. A small clarification is needed. We must consider that not all websites allow their loading within an iframe. Often these loads are blocked. However, for all other cases, we could use this solution. I hope I have correctly answered the subscriber's question. If you have any other questions, feel free to ask, and I will try to answer them. Bye. See you next time.